Mercer Mayer is mostly known for his Little Critter books. From Little Critter learning how to save money or just shopping with his mom, Little Critter is always up to something and off on a new adventure. His other works include The Bravest Knight and Here's There's Something series. Mayer often uses fables and adventures in his Little Critter books, which has Little Critter experiencing small adventures and lessons that can be used in real life. Children are more inclined to connect with his fables and learn from them, as the characters in his books are animals and keep them interested. When it comes to his There's Something series, Mayer uses more of a fantasy adventure where his main characters find themselves facing fears such as there's an alligator under my bed, where a little boy fears that an alligator has been hiding under his bed. He then gathers up the courage to trick the alligator into moving out by gathering food from the fridge and making a trail from his room to the garage. Mayer's fantasy adventure books often start off with a fear and end on a positive note that show the children in the book being the hero. Mercer Mayer also has a fairy tale adventure side where he writes about his characters pretending to be someone they look up to, just like in The Bravest Knight. His main character in this book has a bright and playful imagination that comes to life throughout the book. He portrays a king's bravest knight and helps him fight off bad knights and rescue fair ladies, even fight the terrible giant troll in the end. He realizes he likes just being a kid.
Through the use of literary elements such as style, point of view, and themes, Mercer Mayer is able to write stories in a way that appeals to children and advances their development and reading comprehension. The literary element of style is vividly portrayed in all of Mercer Mayer's works. He expresses style clearly through the element of voice. Throughout both his Little Critter series and the There's Something series, his characters possess a fun voice with optimistic tones and adventurous attitudes. Through his use of youthful voice, he encourages children through his stories to be excited about life and their little adventures. Next, we play Hide and Seek. I hide so well that my friend won't ever find me. Then I lassoed it. It was hugging my bear as hard as it could. In both the Little Critter books and the There's Something series, Mercer Mayer uses the literary element of point of view to attract children to the perspective of the main character. All of the stories are written in the first person, allowing children to know what the character is thinking and feeling, making them relate these characters and their experiences to their own lives. The Little Critter stories are all centered around commonplace events told from Little Critter's perspective, while the There's Something series are stories told by the children about their imaginary adventures. I followed him down the hall. Here the children are following the main character in a more fantastical adventure where the main character is trying to capture an alligator. Mercer Mayer's books all tell fun stories centered around common themes, including life lessons, adventure, and imagination. Throughout the There's Something series, the characters all go on their own mini-adventures, which portray the excitement of growing up and childhood. A lot of these stories have imaginary approaches and fantastical adventures. Every day I do chores to earn more money. Finally, I save enough money for a new skateboard.
Mercer Mayer uses more of a cartoon-style art to portray his characters and make the books more appealing to his audience in his Little Critter series. With his use of animals and critter-like characters in these books, he is able to draw the children's attention in and help the child connect to the situation. His use of bright, bold colors really helps to tell the story, setting the theme or the mood for the books. The whole school came to watch, and you know what? The little kids won. So I guess sometimes being small is just big enough. In the There's Something series, he uses more of a realism art approach, having a boy or a girl as a main character as well as a monster to keep the story together. In two of his books, Mayer uses brighter and more vivid colors to tell the story, whereas in There's a Nightmare in My Closet, he sticks to a more dull pattern using three colors, red, green, and gray. As soon as the room was dark, I heard him creeping towards me. Quickly, I turned on the light and caught him sitting at the foot of my bed. "Go away, Nightmare, or I'll shoot you," I said. How Mayer creates his illustrations is by using Apple Macs with several G5s and 21 and 23-inch cinema displays. He draws his concepts right on the tablet, making it easier to help with these creations.
Mercer Mayer's Little Critter and There's Something series, along with his other works, are timeless, teaching kids to love the adventure that is growing up.